On this fast fix has to do with the newer 2.9 Deutz engine. Pretty much in every JLG boom lift sizzle uses this engine. This code will show up on your analyzer, on your display, if it has one of the newer displays. So it's 437, and it'll say engine code 100:1. And that relates to low oil pressure or oil pressure below threshold. At idle, it needs to be above a certain number, about 25 PSI. When it drops below that for a certain amount of time or extended amount of time, will cause the engine to shut down. Now, don't worry, this isn't typically a big problem 99% of the time. It's the oil pressure regulator. It's got a little burr or a little piece of debris in it, causing it to stay off-seated, causing low oil pressure. I'm going to show you where that's at, how to clean it out. Won't cost you a thing besides, oh, probably a minute of your time. And it's a quick thing to try before you condemn the engine or go down the rabbit hole trying to find a oil pressure gauge to plug into it. So follow along. Now, if you have a JLG analyzer, the screen is very similar, but you'll see code 437 on here. You can go into detail, say engine trouble code 100:1. That's relating to the one we're talking about here. So that confirms the fault code, why it runs for, well, let's say 15, 20 seconds and shuts down. Now, what actually is happening, then I'll show you what you can do on the engine side here. If it has a sky powered generator, this is a big old thing here, point of reference, this little housing here, there's a fitting straight up in the bottom there, and that's where the oil pressure regulator is actually situated on this engine. There's an Allen head screw in there. Pull that out, you'll see a spring and a little valve in here. So I'm going to get this out of here, that way you can kind of see what it looks like and know what you're looking at if you go to take this apart. All right, do is break that thing loose. Well, once it pops loose, it turns pretty easily. What I would suggest doing is lay a rag or a shop towel down. That way when you pull this thing out, you might find the piece of debris that was stuck there. A lot of times it's just a chunk of block casting from when they cast the engine block, and it just kind of breaks itself loose from the channels. Now on the super rare occasion, you take this plug out, the plunger inside or the valve actually gets stuck in the bore. Sometimes the other situation is it gets a little burr in it, and then what happens is it gets jammed up, and I've actually had to, you know, bump the engine over and just start it literally for like half a second, shut off, let the oil pressure push this valve out. Same reason you kind of put a catch rag down there. But once you pull this loose, here's the cap, just an Allen head screw, copper washer to keep it sealed, and here's your regulator valve or plunger, and here's your spring that keeps it on its seat. Now what'll happen is on the seat here, you might find a little blemish or a burr or something. I'm not seeing anything on this one necessarily. But typically, sometimes just taking it loose will dislodge what's in there. So 99% of the time, this will fix that code. Just taking this out, wash it, clean it, wipe it down. If it's burr, a little polish is like 800 grit or really, really, really fine polishing cloth. And just kind of take off any kind of burr or an edge. And this valve, when you reinstall it, should move nice and free. So you can put your finger on the end of the spring. Well, it all kind of dumps back out of the bottom. I'm going to call that how it's supposed to work. Tuck that back up into place. And don't forget the old copper seal there. Kind of hold it all up in place. And just run this thing back in. That all tightened up. Let's go back over here. Check our results. Of course, powering on won't give you anything out of the ordinary. It's only when it loses oil pressure. So go ahead and start it up. And if it runs for more than 10 seconds, I would say you've actually got a winner here. There you go. No fault codes, continues to run. Now, if you had an analyzer plugged into it, you can pull up the oil pressure on the screen and watch that it's more than 25. It's probably close to about 45 PSI now. There you have it, 100:1, low oil pressure or below threshold code causes a shutdown. I've probably only seen one or two engines actually be the mechanical problem with this. Most of the time, it's this valve gets popped open partially. So pull that out, clean it out, takes a couple minutes, doesn't cost you anything but a little bit of your time. Try that first. If it doesn't fix it, well then go down the diagnostic path to figure out why it has low oil pressure. But I would say when this code pops up, 98% of the time, this is the solution. Get you going back down the road. Again, appreciate your time checking this out. If you like what you see, of course, hit the old like button. Want for more, hit the subscribe. I do put a link in the
description on the video, my email. Got any questions, concerns, or a problem you might have and need a solution for, let me know. Again, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
This doesn't happen without you watching this. If you could, please subscribe. Keep me going. Like I said, send me some more information on what you have. Maybe I've got the solution. Thanks again for watching.